I sure do love Sonic the Hedgehog. I mean, this guy was my entire childhood. I grew up playing each and every installment of the series, watching Sonic X every Saturday morning, and playing with Sonic toys. Some of my core formative memories include the guy, so I think it's safe to say that Sonic held an influential part in my upbringing. After releasing my last video, I decided to take a couple days just to chill and not really work on anything. So I did as I usually do and played some Sonic Unleashed, one of my favorite games in the Sonic franchise. I love blasting through the daytime stages at mock speed, it's an absolute thrill. Then after I was done replaying Windmill Isle for the 473rd time, I went to go play some Sonic Frontiers just to chip away at it. And I felt that something was off. I've noticed that as time progresses, Sonic Team is getting lazier and lazier, specifically in the animation department. Now, I'm not talking about in-game cutscenes, although they're not doing the best over there either. I'm referencing the way that Sonic moves. Here, take a look at the rail switching animation in Sonic Unleashed. Now look at Sonic Frontiers. Which game do you think was released in 2008, and which one do you think was released in 2022? I think we all know the answer to that. I'm using two YouTube videos running at 60 FPS for this comparison. Sonic Unleashed has 48 unique frames of animation from the time he starts his jump to when he lands and you're able to make another move. Every single frame has Sonic smoothly switching from rail to rail with a unique position. In Sonic Frontiers, I counted 28 frames. You might be thinking that 48 frames versus 28 frames, it's not that much. But in that time, only 14 frames of animation are unique. Sonic holds the same stance for 10 whole frames. This is so lazy. Not to mention that his arc is so weird, it looks unnatural. I will say that this is all me counting frames, so I may have some numbers a little off, but it's so noticeable. Sonic Unleashed, a game released 14 years before Sonic Frontiers, looks more lively and fluid than a game from the same series today. It's little things like these that make games feel so sloppy. The same goes for the jumping animation. Let's use Sonic Unleashed again here. The amount of frames here isn't my issue, since the time between jumping and getting curled into a ball is very quick. But my issue is with how Sonic looks during his jump. In Sonic Unleashed, and Generations as well for that matter, Sonic can be seen inside of his blue aura. He exists inside this ball and he is jumping. It looks great, it adds depth to his jump. Nowadays, he turns into a solid blue blob. This isn't a new development though. It's as early as Sonic Colors that the animation has been like this. But even in Sonic Colors, there's layers to his jump. There's a lighter blue outside of the darker blue in the center. And it looks decent enough. Once again, where is the life in these animations? Let's study some animations in Sonic Generations for a second. Look at these trick animations. They look amazing and they're so stylized. Sonic is doing genuinely cool tricks and pulling really fun poses, like this iconic pose from Sonic Adventure. There is care and thought put into these tricks. Sonic Team didn't need to include this pose, but they did because it's a cool nod to the older games. Here's Sonic Frontiers. Are they even tricks? Because they're supposed to be. Where's the character? These animations are so quick. And for what? Again, it just makes me so sad. The reason that this is so frustrating to me is because Sonic Team actually did a stellar job with Sonic's running animation in Frontiers. I think it's the best running animation he's had in any game. See the way he smoothly builds up speed and how his animation scales with it seamlessly. Look at the way that Sonic leans into his turns. It even looks great when making drastic directional changes. It looks amazing. So why does his rail switching animation look like this? I also really like a lot of the attack animations, they look great. You can tell there was effort put into these. Where is that love for every single area of this game? Now, I'm not saying anything negative about the gameplay in Sonic Frontiers, because I actually have a lot of fun running around the open zone to my heart's content. I generally like the game. I just want to criticize where Sega and Sonic Team have been cutting corners, ruining the gameplay experience. You might think I'm nitpicking, and yeah, ultimately these things are minute details. But what's next? What soul are we gonna get stripped from us next? The worst part is that Sega is getting away with this. The bar is set so low for Sonic that Frontiers is seen as a godsend. And yes, the gameplay's fun, and that's what ultimately matters the most. But people are overlooking the glaring issues that are in this game. Let's take a look at what games that Sonic Frontiers was up against in the 2022 Game Awards. Sonic Frontiers was nominated for Player's Choice, and it came in second place behind Genshin Impact, which pretty much cheated its way to the win, let's be honest. Sonic Frontiers was a huge margin above games like Elden Ring, God of War Ragnarok, and Stray. Let's take a quick look into the love and care that was put into making these games as polished as possible. Specifically Elden Ring. Look at this beautiful, ginormous castle waiting to be explored. It's grand and it gets you pumped to get in there and fight some monsters. Now let's look at Sonic Frontiers. I want to put it out there that I don't blame the developers for anything that I've mentioned in this video. Instead, I blame corporate deadlines set in place by Sega. It's clear that Sonic Frontiers is an unfinished game. This is literally confirmed by the Sonic Frontiers 2023 DLC roadmap. In the coming updates, Sonic Team is going to be adding things that should have been in the game from the very start that they clearly didn't have enough time to implement. Update 1 has a jukebox, photo mode, and challenge modes being added to the game. All three of these things are bonus features that many games today already have when they come out. Update 2 sees Sonic's birthday, whatever that entails, open zone challenges, and new Coco. Then Update 3 adds new playable characters and a new story. All of these DLC are free, which makes me think that they were always being intended to be in the game, but there wasn't enough time for these things to be added for the initial release. Sega is getting away with doing the least, and they're getting praised for it. As Sonic fans, I think we should expect quality out of what we're getting, especially after 5 years of radio silence. We shouldn't be getting stripped of the simple things. Sega is more concerned with holiday deadlines instead of making a genuinely stunning game. Sonic Frontiers has the meat of an amazing Sonic game, but what's a good steak without good greens and a nice hearty side of mashed taters? We deserve better.